only people that really were on my side were my parents, who told me, if you want to listen to somebody else's orders all your life and work the hours you don't want and make terrible money, don't go to college.
People were always telling me that I wasn't smart enough, that I wasn't good enough to like make it into college.
We all have dreams, and the only way to put foundations under it is to get an education.
After my first year in college at the university, they told me not to come back.
You don't see many Latinos, you know, teachers or professors.
I was always the only black in most of my classes.
It was suggested that instead of being locked up in juvenile hall, that maybe I should consider joining the military.
I would like to be a biomedical engineer, a computer and hardware design engineer. You know, I have all these different dreams.
And someone says, oh, you're such a dreamer. What you should say is, thank you, I am a dreamer. Because I think we should never give up dreaming. The return to the sand.
I was educated here on the Navajo Reservation. I finished high school here, Shiprock High School, and I got accepted to the University of New Mexico. After my first year in college at the university, they told me not to come back. I'm from the University of California, Berkeley, and I'm in the Department of Molecular and Cell Biology, where I'm a postdoctoral fellow. I'm studying the intracellular control of calcium.
Molecular biology research go real well hand in hand.
I went to Navajo Community College with my resolution to do well, to learn how to write, to learn to do the mathematics, to learn to communicate better.
I remember the days I was here, just like you.
And eventually I finished my bachelor's degree at Fort Lewis College. I ended up at the best university for graduate school education, University of California, Berkeley, and I finished there. I am the first American Indian to get a doctorate in science at that particular institution since it was built 100 years ago. You know, if I can do it and I came from here, all of you can do that too. You just have to keep focused on some goal ahead of you.
They don't teach you this at Berkeley.
I'm the first one in all my generations to attend a university.
Minorities are portrayed ignorant. And then being a woman, you're portrayed ignorant.
I think what has motivated me most to go to college was after I got married, I had my children. And I started seeing what a need there was for good doctors.
I really do think there's a lack of female role models out there, especially of color.
They weigh a lot more. Do you want to show me that?
Sure. I've had so many students now come into the laboratory and tell me how important it is to see other women and other minorities in medicine and try to understand how they got there, how they arranged their lives, and to have someone take a special interest in them. Colleen Bugs is a student in my laboratory who came through the Hughes for one of the summer training programs.
It would compete off binding.
And she's won a number of awards for excellent research for medical students and graduate students.
Of the competitor DNA did you use?
She's just been a source of great pleasure and pride.
And tenant H&F4. I found something that's kind of interesting.
When I entered college at the University of Pennsylvania, I realized that I had to really reach out and meet other students, graduate students, professors, and find a way to really survive in that competitive environment. And that's what I did. I would literally walk up to people, and I would say, oh, I heard that you were a biochemistry major. How do you like the curriculum? What advice would you give a freshman? During college, I started to consider an MD-PhD program.
Are you on any type of medication?
And once again, a professor said, oh, you don't want to do that. You know, it's too difficult. It's not a smart thing. Just decide on one degree.
That's the main thing that is a problem for students at the high school and at the college level, is that they don't reach high enough sometimes because of a few words of discouragement.
During undergrad, I did research at UCLA, and that was a turning point in my life because I met a black woman, Dr. Ernestina Saxton, and that's all I needed to see was this black woman with an MD and a PhD degree, and she was a mother. She's a wonderful mentor, and I knew that it was possible. You know, it wasn't just some fantasy.
If you see other African Americans have achieved their goals, it encourages you to shoot for the stars.
My solution, a chemical, scientifically physical, the drum reaction, the sticks refracting, the spread of molecular chain reaction, drumming with the pound of communication, education through drum vibration. It's like chemistry in the form of poetry, like a dope documentary, a complexity of electron infinity. Here, take, read my philosophy. Chemical compounds form the logical and turn chains to physical. Chip my interaction, a lyrical attraction, a chemical, electrical style, electrostatical. I kick scientific chemicals.
We have developed a program for inner city youth that has been funded by the Howard Hughes Institute. And this program is aimed at giving inner city minorities the resources to pursue adventures in science. We have a young man in the program, Otis Robinson, who reminds me a lot of the experiences that I had in wanting to pursue science. The Pre-College Science Collaborative is a fruition of a dream that I've had all my life. Now, I'm the last of 15 children. I come from a very traditional Puerto Rican family, and no one had ever gone to college. So that, to me, was a dream come true.
Thinking this time to get a...
Students engaged in our program spent 2 years doing scientific inquiry guided by a science mentor. And what's so interesting is that Otis is working with Dr. Anderson, who was also my mentor.
I think it's like this myth that science is boring, it's for nerds. You know, the science isn't that stereotype that we always hear about.
Run it up.
This one goes up.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
It's about exploring and opening up new doors.
This is nice, you know, because I've been working with these bacteria, and I never really got a chance to, like, look at it this close under such high magnification.
When you're looking on an electron microscope, it's amazing the way you can see a whole new world within this world.
That's amazing.
We've gone on trips to Mexico. We've gone to the temples in Cancun, the Mayan ruins, and I've started to learn a lot about my roots. And I found out that these Indians, they found the paths of the stars, and these calendars, NASA even uses, they're so accurate. We're scientists. If our roots could do it, we could do it.
I specialize in neuropsychology and brain imaging. I do research in memory with Alzheimer's disease patients. I come from a strong Latino background. I didn't pay too much attention to school, and there were other things to entertain me and my friends. You could say my criminal activity heightened to the point of where I was finally arrested for carrying a machine gun around with me. I joined the military just a couple days after my 17th birthday. I got sent to Panama, where I met a very lovely young woman. So I left the military, I took the GED test, and then I went to a community college.
Cool.
The turning point was when I actually got to meet Dr. Eloy Rodriguez at UC Irvine. It blew my mind to see a Mexican-American professor.
Now, as you get into
a world-famous researcher, he ended up starting a research program, which became the Howard Hughes undergraduate research program.
Biochemical research, you gotta have your chemistry.
He had been there for me as an undergraduate every day, and he's still there for me now, making sure that I am succeeding here.
What's also very interesting with this new PET scanner is that it also shows some frontal region.
It wasn't any magic that Eloy did with me. He didn't turn me into a genius. He just basically shared with me the things that he had learned, the right roads to take, and that's what I try to do now with students who take the courses that I offer.
There's not a lot of activity going on.
aspirin, as you know, comes from the willow tree. How does it work?
I grew up in a predominantly Chicano Mexican-American community in Texas, in a town that was in really the poorest county per capita in the United States, where crime really didn't pay.
People always ask me, what is your greatest discovery? My great discovery, those young students who themselves are going to be the future scientists.
Hey, guys, let's look at some of this butterfly. Let me see.
We have a program called the Kids Program, Kids Investigating Discovering Science.
Maybe you can tell us the different parts of that butterfly. And you know what's interesting? This plant is used to cure cancer in children. Did you know that?
The whole idea here is just to continue to keep them motivated, excited about the whole aspect of discovery.
See that? Look at the proboscis. Ah. ¿Por qué se cerran las hojas? Why do the leaves close? Everybody has a chance to give a guess.
Most of the people that I associate